In my flesh.
Oh,
celebrate life because there is life after life. Come to celebrate the life of one Sandra Kelley today. We pray and we're thankful to you being here to support this family. Lord, to complete our services in education that we grew up by Reverend Calvin Young, and the scripture reading will follow immediately, and then we will have the selection following the scripture reading by
Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, Father, we are so thankful to you yet once again for blessing us, Father God, in the manner you have. Even in the midst of these testing and trying times, thou art still God. Even in the midst of sorrow, Lord God, your name is yet worthy to be praised. So even on today, Lord God, we come to this family and we celebrate this life of our dear love, who you have all fit to bring our home, Father God, to eternal resting place in you. Although our hearts are heavy and our eyes are filled with tears, we thank you, Father God, for the rejoicing that we have in our heart and knowing that in spite of it all is yet well. Because she's in your ever present right now, Lord God. But we thank you right now for this husband, this family, Lord God, and for all that to make up this great congregation today. But that was truly a testament to the influence that you had on life already. We have the ever on the side of our voice on today, Lord God. And we continue to, Lord God, mourn this loss, Lord God. And yet find rejoicing enough, Lord God, that even in days and months and years to come, that they continue, Lord God, to be encouraged, Lord God, by the impact you have on our lives. But we ask, Father God, that you continue to strengthen this family during these challenging times. We know it will get hard sometimes, Lord God. But nevertheless, Father, we thank you for the memories that yet live on. Because our memories will never die. Help us, O God, to continue to embrace, Father God, the strength of your encouraging word. Because in your word, we can find life, Lord God. So when all that seems to fail, Lord God, help us to realize and recognize, Lord God, that your peace, Father God, which surpasses all understanding, yet can be found in keeping our hearts and our minds stayed on thee. That we may experience that perfect peace. So even on today, Lord God, as we celebrate, as we rejoice, give us a word, Lord God, that we come to our hearts even more in these testing and trying times. Because we know without a doubt, Lord God, the pressure and the strength of the Lord are the name of the saints. And there's no question in our hearts and our mind that our sisters have transitioned into your everlasting presence. And for that in itself, we pray, thank you, Lord God, and we bless your holy master name. Now, even in this trying time, even in this hour of sorrow, help us, O Lord God, to lift up our voice in praise and adoration unto you, that your name will yet be glorified, and we, your people, yet may be encouraged and edified to power just a little while longer. We thank you now, Lord. We bless your name. This is our prayer. We pray in Jesus' name. That we all say, amen.
Our scripture reading in the Old Testament is listed in the program, Psalms 90, verse 12. And read this way in the King James Version. So teach us to number our days, that we may acquire our hearts unto wisdom. I read that one more time. So teach us to number our days, that we may acquire our hearts unto wisdom. Our New Testament is in the book of John, Gospel of John, chapter 11, is listed starting verse 18. And it reads this way. Now Bethany was nigh unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlongs off. And many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brother. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him,
but Mary sat still in the house. Then said Martha to Jesus, Lord, if thou hast been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to you. Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. And Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. But Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? She said unto him, yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God, Son of God, which shall come into the world. May the word of God, family, be a comfort to your hearts.
Perfect. music selection at the person presenting. Amen. Give God some praise for our praise God for God. Amen. And we're going to proceed with the reflections.
Thank you, Jesus.
From those that love Sandra, Sister Kelley, I want to just preempt that with comments. She was as faithful as could be in the time that she was doing this fellowship. It was the energy she brought and the excitement she brought was always given the opportunity for her to present herself in some form, one or another, whether it be the women's ministry or even the worship experience. We truly thank God for that. Just tell her for her faithfulness. We want to comfort this family knowing that, I know it sounds cliche, that she's in a better place. So we're going to have reflections and hear from those that represent who come to the podium and utilize the time allowed this time.
Reading about her education and all her achievements in the obituaries, I won't go there. Sam and I helped our adjoining neighborhood operate a voting precinct for elections for many, many years. She even pulled me into working many times with her on vacation, not the school, and other youth ministry past she chaired while we were both members of Shiloh Baptist Church. We look forward to prayer meeting times with our own neighborhood woman's prayer group. We were both involved in other neighborhood association activities together, and we would often pick each other up to go to these events. Sandra was such a sweet, caring lady, and she had a wonderful Christian spirit about her. She never doubted around with gossip or hearsay conversations, and if you know her, you know that's true. She kept a positive attitude and demonstrated her Christian faith in every aspect of her life. She was a true friend to me and to so many of you who are gathered here this morning. And we will miss her and our close-knit neighborhood as well. Church, friendship is one of life's greatest treasures. So, in honor of our dear friend, Sister Sandra, let's all try to be kinder to others, show compassion and patience in whatever space you encounter, and live a life full of hope and faith for the future. Share in a meaningful, enduring friendship with someone. You may say, Sandra passed away, but I say, thank God she passed my way. May God bless this family with strength for the days ahead and pleasant memories to comfort you on this journey. Because, as someone shared with Adrian yesterday, her love will always be in your heart and in mine too. God bless you.
Anybody else going through all the emotions, and it's just for, you know, the life that you can never imagine something ever happens to my mom. And it took a lot of prayer and time for me to finally find peace to come to that realization that your mom truly lived a full life. Your mom was well traveled. She had every magnet on her fridge approved. I was able to see my sisters and myself grow up. She saw me get married. She was able to meet my son, her first grandchild. And then she mom with fashion. She created endless memories of love and laughter and happiness. Even when her days were hard, and everybody can testify to this, mom always had a smile on her face. Always. His mom carried an aura so bright that no matter what had happened that day, just talking to her instantly felt better. That's just who she was. I could go on and on, tell stories, even about the time she kidnapped me. As a kid, it took me to what I call the Florida Mountains. Mom helped life, I know this is Leesburg. I can tell you my mom are the craziest, you know, shucks.
Jiminy Cricket. For that time that she actually did watch my mouth, that was so good. But more importantly, I do want you all to know that Jimon was a true servant of Christ. And as I listened to, you know, the outpour and to hear everybody's different stories about Jimon, I just know she was a servant to others as well. Jimon leaves a legacy, you know, that we can all learn from. And I encourage all of us to strive to be that light that Jimon was. Be that reason someone smiles, be that reason someone laughs. Because of who Jimon was and is, and why she lived on forever. Thank you.
So some of you may refer to her as Sandra, but I recognize her mom. And she can be as Miss Dolly, or Miss Dolly for short. Jimongi was the most timely person I have ever encountered. And no, I don't mean her track record for showing up on time for things, because let's face it, she was late to just about everything. Probably because she was resting her eyes for a little longer than she intended. You know, but the timeliness I am referring to is her ability to sense when she is needed. There were those seasons where I needed an extra laugh, needed some extra love. And of course, out of the blue, she called checking to see if I have everything I need, or asked when I'm free for our next date. It must have been a sixth sense because it never failed. She was always right on time. Not only was she timely, but she was resilient and strong. Apparently, she beat a whole breast cancer diagnosis without me even knowing. I really mean that. I didn't find out until well into my adult years. Her strength was inconceivable. Jimon loved to travel, and she would get a refrigerator magnet of everything she went. I remember thinking how amazing she was for exploring. Sometimes her roaming got her in sticky situations, like when she got lost in a crowd in Washington, D.C. during President Obama's inauguration, or when she wandered off in Times Square in New York City. You know what they say, though. Not all those who wander are lost. She may have been physically been lost in those moments, but spiritually, she was far from lost. She always had purpose. She always had faith. And every chance she got, she was so strong that we live that we should live a life of God centered. She was always giving us our daily bread with the verse, or challenging us to memorize a bit of a Bible chapter. A lot of the reasons we are who we are today is because she helped mold us. And I can't say thank you enough, but I will try anyways. So, Jimon, thank you for making holidays and birthdays so special. Thank you for letting me stay up late to watch HBO channels that I have a sleepover. Thank you for the laughs. Thank you for remembering I don't like nannies and my eggs. Thank you for the no thank you portions. Thank you for my abnormal addiction to apple juice. Thank you for the countless memories. Thank you for the life lessons. Thank you for reminding me that I can be anything in this life if I work for it. Thank you for being the grandmother that all the kids in the neighborhood wish they had. Thank you for being my and our Jimon. May we one day be again.
My image was said, I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Over the last week, I've heard so many stories of how my mom impacted many of you here. Many of you watching the live stream, and many of you who she worked with, fellowship with, and those she just met in passing. My mom, Sandra M.B, was a blessing to me and the family. As a mother, she was that woman that brought home the bacon as an educator. She did fry it up in a pan. She cooked 3 meals a day. And she never let my dad forget he was a man. Yes, she was that woman. She loved baking, and I know many of you will miss her five-plate pound cake, her lemon squares, Christmas cookies, hot cross buns, and many other desserts. She was a rock to my family as she helped us with picking up and babysitting. And not for a day would she babysit, but even for a whole weekend. She was that grandmother my friends wished they were. And my kids shared their new mothers with their friends. She also loved her son-in-law, my husband Ron, and made him feel like he was her own son, even when he was in the doghouse with me. And my mom, she loved her sisters in AKA, and I know they loved her. I would always shake my head because I thought she was doing the most. She was adamant to learn every AKA dance routine. And when she could, she was on the side holding up her mirrors. And she was scheming for her sisters. Yes, she had AKA sisters that helped her bring the drama, allowing her to AKA stroll and swag surfing at the age of 75. But they also helped her navigate the technology world and whatever she needed. But more importantly, she provided a foundation of what it is to be a Christian. She knew how to exemplify love. I have heard words such as sweet, nice, caring, thoughtful, but she was also firm and made sure we as kids were disciplined and gave great advice to everyone. I will miss her here on earth, but I know she is in God's kingdom, praising him for all his goodness and making sure everyone she encounters feels the love. My final words to my mom were thank you for allowing me to be here, darling.
Resolution of respect and loving memory of Sandra M.B. Kelley. We are today comforted by the words of our Lord in Revelation 21:4, which says, "And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away." Whereas Sandra Allen Kelley passed from this life on March 17, 2022, and whereas the death does not diminish the profound benediction of a life lived in such godly service, nor our admiration of and affection for her husband, Prince Kelley, and children, Prince Ann Kelley and Adrian Bell, her spouse, Ron Bell, and her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Whereas our beloved embraced the all-forgiving presence of God from earliest days and strove to exhibit the same qualities of compassion throughout an exemplary life, and therefore be it resolved that we embraced this bereaved family in our common bond of grief and remembrance of a beloved soul. Therefore, be it further resolved that we bow to a greater will than our own and rest in the knowledge that one day we will be united again in joy and in the fullness of God's mercy, humbly submitted in faith and appreciation for the gift of our time, Reverend Raleigh H. Allen IV, March 26th. Acknowledging resolution from the city of Orlando, Mayor Lynn Dyer. Also acknowledging resolutions from Bible-based Fellowship Church, Reverend Anthony C. White, Dean Castle. Resolution of respect and loving memory of Sandra. No matter what your trials are or how big your mountain seems, the Lord is there to see you. He'll go to all extremes.
seems hard to bear, and you know not what to do, the one who loves us the most will be there to see you through. Whereas, in the providence of God, he has sought to bring a close of life to Sandra Gavin Kelley, to the sweet rest and fellowship of the saints in heaven. And whereas, Sister Kelley joined Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church on December 7, 2008, under the leadership of Reverend Willie C. Barnes. She is the wife of Brother Prince Kelley, also a faithful member of Macedonia. Therefore, let it be known that we know that your loss is deep and your sorrow is great. But more importantly, we recognize that this is our loss, but heaven's gain. The Lord has accepted into his presence a good and faithful servant, now ready to receive her crown of righteousness. We are certain that she will be sorely missed, but will forever remain in your hearts. Earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Be resolved that the pastor and deacons of Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church join every member in extending our deepest sympathy to the Kelley family and commend them to the Heavenly Father, who is too wise to make a mistake, and he is too just to err. Although it may be difficult to see beyond the sorrow, may looking back in memory help comfort you on tomorrow. Lastly, be it resolved that a copy of this resolution be tendered to the family as a token of our love and esteem, and a copy placed in the archives of the church. Respectfully submitted on this day, the 26th day of March, Reverend Willie C. Barnes, Pastor, J. Charity Ware, Church Clerk. We, family of the late Sandra Allen Kelley, G. Mommy, are grateful to God for the gift of her life. We wish to express our heartfelt thanks for all the gestures of kindness shown to us during our time of bereavement. The outpouring of love and support expressed to our family is evidence of the impact Sandra's life had on the lives of the people she touched. We take comfort in 1 Corinthians 2:9. Eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor has it entered into the heart of him, that things which God has prepared for those who love him. Amen.
I think I want to have a video presentation now, please.
Thank you.
People of God, say amen.
Amen.
Say amen again. We have appreciated so much, but eulogy has already been given. And we are thankful to the expressions that touch the heart of all of us. And we know that this is not a time that we commonly rejoice, but yet the scripture teaches us we should. As a matter of fact, it is the comforting of the scripture that helps us to get through these periods, because there is a different reaction for those of us who have faith in Christ and those that don't believe. And we are thankful to God. I just want to take just a few minutes to reflect upon the scripture that serves us well in these times, especially in times of death. In the book of 1 Thessalonians, Apostle Paul writes, beginning at verse chapter 4, verse 13, he said, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them that are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. But if we believe that Jesus died and rose, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with the shout, with the voice of an archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remaining shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we ever be with the Lord." I love this final word. "Wherefore, comfort one another with these words." Not necessarily attacking the subject, but I like to use this thought. Caught up together. Caught up together in the clouds. In this time, we feel such heartache and pain and loss. Scripture offers us so much comfort. It offers us so much encouragement, even expresses victory. As a matter of fact, in Jesus' teaching, he uses sleep instead of death. Seeing that in the writing of the Thessalonian believers, Paul knew that the church was experiencing some difficulties of loss of loved ones. Those who were hurting, that was those who were grieving. He offers reason of hope. And today, we know that Sandra Kelley was a believer. We know that. So it's not the time we come to this moment, so I'm not coming to preach to snakes. What do you know? Because the Bible said that it teaches us that if this old earthly house of this tabernacle be dissolved, we have another building. For Sandra, it's moving time. For Sandra, it's time to transition. We often talk about transition here in the church today, but the fact is, for Sandra, it is the reality of a
transition to the new life. Concept Paul to teach us to be comforted with this idea of death that we see in the scriptures today. That sorrow be a merciful relief to a soul that is bereaved. Here he's talking about, I don't want you to be ignorant. I don't want us to act as if we don't have hope. It's just a reminder. For I know that there are some of us here who do believe in Christ and believe in the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ. But we have to understand that sorrow itself is a merciful relief. Sorrow is nowhere forbidden in the teachings of Scripture. Amen. It may be an infirmity, but it is not. It is at a time, at the same time, it's a solace. But Jesus said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. And I love that expression because even though I mourn now, I have the hope and trust in God that the promise is, I will understand it better. I will know. I will come to a place. I want to say that, Brother Kelley. I know that nothing wrong with your song, nothing wrong with your grief. But you will come to know comfort. That's promised by Christ. You come to know it. You shall be comforted. And in this expression, it talks about, it also expresses that sorrow for those that die is aggravated, watch this, by ignorance of their future destiny. The radius of hope is contracted or expanded in proportion to the character and the extent of the intelligence that you possess. Your sorrow can be aggravated if you don't understand the future of the one that's past. So Paul said, I want you to be ignorant. I mean, you know, I understand, but understand that sorrow is an infirmity that we find solace in. That those who don't believe, who have no satisfactory knowledge of a future life, is those who don't know the Lord Jesus. As Paul teaches to the church of Thessalonica, he's teaching them that I know you got some loved ones that you lost, but at the same time, I don't want you to be ignorant about that loss. So the message of Christ in the foundation for the life that we've been given, Jesus comes to give us life. We have that foundation of trusting in what he has done for us, his promises. So, let me express one more point about sorrow and I'll move on. That sorrow for those that die in Christ is actually soothing. No, it don't sound logical. And it is moderated by certain truths concerning their blessing. That death is actually sleep.
Yes, it is. Glory.
That sleep is expression of refreshment.
Yes, sir.
We talk about it. On this side, sickness grow there. New life. And anticipate the day when they will be first to see the resurrected Christ return for his people.
Pause in just a minute. But Sister Kelley, she had a privilege at this point better than you. Number two, the important reality of the importance of the triumph return of Christ. We are told that the Lord, watch this, himself. Shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God. In other words, it ain't gonna be no hidden major scene coming.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, glory. Thanks.
Every eye gonna see that. When Christ comes for the second time, he won't be wrapped up in a swaddling cloth. He won't be announced by a single star. There won't be the wise men. I wish I had a church.
All right.
Walking in the shepherds, you will come wrapped up in glorious splendor to stand in the clouds.
Glory.
And what a reunion is going to be. After the deceased saints are resurrected, to be with Christ in his glory, then we which are remain. You know what? It can happen at any moment.
That's right.
Here we are. So my brothers and sisters, I come to share with you today that we're going to come together. Sister Kelley will be together with us.
Yes.
With those of you who believe.
Yes.
In the Bible.
Yes.
That's the meeting place. That's the reunion place.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah.
If you allow the reality of the scripture to speak to us, Jesus is coming back. That's why we live with him, because he's coming back. The conclusive teaching of Christ is this. When he came to Martha and Mary in that hour, they said, Lord, if you had been here, I'm pretty sure, even in the praying that, in that last hour we prayed and suspect and family, we decided to say, Lord, do a miracle. Lord, if they had just been here, my brother would have not died. Lord, if they had just been here, Sister Sandra would have died. Watch Jesus. Your brother will be able to.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, your brother will live again. And then they decide to get religious. I know he will in the resurrection. Jesus, hold up. I am. So in that hour of sleeping,
I hear Jesus saying, from Kelley, I am the resurrection. He that believed in me, though he was dead, yet shall she live. Just like in most of the time, Jesus demonstrates who he is by doing a practical demonstration of the power he has. We're not asking Jesus to raise up to sinners, but he had to do it because he came to show us who he was. It's not about raising up from the dead, it's about Jesus who has power. To kill right. Show me where your land is. Where God, he's speaking by now. Jesus said, I ain't asking you. Show me where you went to the graves. Call Lazarus. Lazarus, come forth. You know, like the friend who called him 2-3 times. Jesus can do that. Lazarus demonstrated that he had power over life and death.
Mm-hmm.
So, according to the promise of the gospel, we finish. Paul said, comfort one another with these words.
Yeah.
How do I comfort? Well, you got to come alongside those who sorrow. You got to come along. That word comfort in paraphrase means to come alongside. Come alongside with the words of the scripture. Let the scripture escort you through this pain. Let the scripture comfort you in the fact that Jesus is coming back again.
Yes, he is.
So he said, don't be troubled. So one day, we who believe will be caught up in the clouds. To go back to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And the church said, amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Believe it, believe it, don't you believe it, I'm here. Even if
Come on.